CFD presentation over cross-flow heat exchangers by Avrion Guiano, Josh Bonnet, and Greg Adams. An introduction to CFD, computational fluid dynamics, is a branch of fluid mechanics that runs iterations on calculations to converge on a stable solution and uses the stable solution to predict a pattern of flow, pressure, and temperature. CFD is important because it gives the opportunity to use numerical values to create realistic effects of a piece of equipment that saves money and saving time. A few examples are automotive design, airfoil designs, heat transfer solutions, and pressure vessel designs.
For our project, we chose a generic problem very common in industry. At first, when you look at a cross-flow heat exchanger, most have circular pipes as for cross-flow. These circular pipes introduce extra turbulence into the system and decrease the outlet pressure, and sometimes they require an extra pump to help supplement the flow. For our problem, we analyzed other pipe designs to allow an easier flow while retaining the same thermal contact and still heat and cool the liquid efficiently. For our alternate pipe design, we ran the traditional circular pipes. We also tried a new ovular pipe, which is a little bit more elongated. And we also tried the triangular pipes.
2 hours later.
As far as meshing goes, we used a variety of different methods to make sure our mesh was fine as possible. We used max mesh size, we used number of divisions, setting it to a high number, and also lowering the growth rate and enabling smoothing. As far as setup goes, we used our K-epsilon-2 equation system for our viscous model, standard wall functions. Our tubes are at 280 degrees Kelvin, and our inlet is 2 meters per second fluid with a thermal value of 370 Kelvin. When it was time to run the calculation, we set our time step size to 0.05 seconds and a number of steps to 300, with 20 iterations per time step.
Approximately 10 hours later.
From hot to cold, from hot to cold, from hot to cold. Heat transfer goes from hot to cold, from hot to cold, from hot to cold, from hot to cold, from hot to cold. Heat transfer is really neat, it always goes from hot to cold. You'll always remember this kid easy, even when you're getting old. When you go out to dinner, you want food that is super real hot. But if you wait too long to eat, oh, you'll be so sad with what you got. See what happens, it's really easy. The food is sitting out and touching the air. The heat from your food's not disappearing, it's being transferred to the air. Cause heat transfer is really neat. It always goes from hot to cold, from hot to cold, from hot to cold.
After we ran the calculations on a workbench, we calculated the average facet value from the program. The average facet value was basically the temperature of the outlet. And so for the circular pipes, it came out to 338.6 degrees Kelvin. For the ovular, it came out to 344.17 degrees Kelvin. And for triangular, it was 341.89 degrees Kelvin. So as you can see, there wasn't a whole lot of difference between the three, but the circular did cool the most and the ovular did cool the least.
As you can observe from the animation of the circular pipe flow, there were some turbulence. But the turbulence allowed better heat transfer, and the circular construction also is ease of construction because the pipes can go in either way, and it also included the highest value of heat transfer. But the cons for the circular pipes were head loss pressure drop, and a more powerful pump was required.
For the ovular pipe design in the heat exchanger, they did have the lowest amount of pressure drop across the heat exchanger and the lowest amount of turbulence in it. However, they also had the lowest amount of heat transfer rate, and during construction, the orientation of the tubes would matter, so it would not be very easy construction.
Although the triangular heat exchanger design was more effective than the ovular design, there were also many cons, which included extreme turbulence, very difficult to construct, as well as a very expensive project.
In conclusion, the circular design cooled the fluid by 32 degrees through the heat exchanger, the ovular design cooled it by 27 degrees, and the triangular design cooled it by 29 degrees. We can observe from this that the overall heat transfer effectiveness has not changed drastically. However, in some applications, a lesser pressure drop, as seen in the elliptical design, may be a considerable option.
Thank you.
Heat transfer is really neat. It always goes from hot to cold, from hot to cold, from hot to cold.